When I was little, it seemed everyone had glasses. My mother, my grandparents, my relatives, my friends. I thought they made people look cool or more grown up. So if I wanted to become one or the other or both, I had to get my own glasses. When I was 14, I told my mother I was getting headaches and I thought I needed glasses. She took me to the doctor. As he looked into my eyes with a gizmo, I crossed them slightly. Amblyopia, the doctor told my mom. Strabismus, heterotropia, something like that. His eyes are slightly crossed, he needs glasses. I spent a long time picking out frames.
Danny.
Well.
When my glasses finally arrived, I put them on excitedly. A week later, my mom asked me where they were. Why aren't you wearing your glasses? They were expensive. I didn't want to tell her that they gave me a headache until, conveniently, I lost them. A decade later, I married a girl with glasses. I got in-laws with glasses. Then I had a son, and he got glasses too. In my mid-40s, I started getting headaches again. I could only read in bed with a lamp on. I had a tough time with restaurant menus. My friends called it short arm syndrome. Someone lent me a pair of drugstore glasses. I was amazed at how much better I could see. It had been so gradual, but it was beyond denying. Presbyopia. A gradual thickening and loss of flexibility of the lens inside my eyes that make it tough to focus on things that are near. I like my glasses for what they do for me. I'm less thrilled about what they say about me. Welcome to middle age. So far, I don't wear my glasses when I draw. I can see what I'm drawing without them. Not being able to see the page clearly is fine. I know what I'm making. There's the added pleasure of putting on my glasses when I'm done, to examine the lines on the page as they really look. My eyes have brought me a lot of pleasure. I count on them to make a living, to make art, to watch my wife brush her teeth. And I'll need them for a while to come, I hope. But nonetheless, they're changing. A reminder that every day, so am I. And so is everything I see.